How are you? Now we are ready to receive the word of God, and as we welcome the word of God, let's give the flowers. Let's clap our hands.
The reading was read earlier and it was clear. I'm just going to the headings and then go ahead with what was read. Just like we heard in Isaiah. That God Himself said this to His children. That look for me while, seek for me while I can still be found. Call me while I'm still close. Those of us who are going to call him, or those of us who are going to seek him, let us all get out from our evil ways. Let us leave the wrong ways and let us leave all the evil things that we have been thinking of. Let us turn to our Lord because He has mercy for us. He forgives us without us paying any ransom. Is this not something good that God has spoken to us? Is this not something good that us, children of God are supposed to fill up this place. If God is someone who forgives us, who can stand before him that he did not sin? Who among you did not sin? All of us sin. But if we go to him, he has forgiveness for us. What are we waiting? It is a good time now. If I see there's no people have already forgotten what God has done to them. There are a lot of things that we cannot break on the
couch
that God has done to you and for me. But we all forgot. We forgot and we have returned back to doing our evil things. We have got other gods that we know. Because we know that even money is God. Anything that you see that is beautiful, you go back to it and say that that's your God. And you have forgotten the God that created you. You have left the God that has mercy on you.
We are
the children of God. Where are the children that were here that God has blessed them, that God has cleansed them? Where are all God's children? The few of you that
are here,
don't leave the world. Because he said every sin that you have committed, he will forgive you. He said he is a God of mercy, he can forgive.
See,
and for real, can people really think and then leave God? No. And just like he has also said in the book of Psalms, that we as children of God, let us come before him and cry for him. He said, let us cry to the Lord, let us cry to him with all our sins and for the bad things that we have done, whether in sickness or because we are poor, let us all cry to the Lord. Is there anybody among you who do not have any thoughts or trouble that you are going through? If we are asked, each one of us, we can be able to tell what problems we are facing. The healings that we received here, and then there are people that are crying at that time for healing. And they did not get, and they are crying inside that pain. Let us cry to the Lord. This is the time that we should not
forget.
In every pain of yours, do not
leave.
In every poorness that you are going through, do not leave the Lord. In every sadness that you are going through, you should not leave the Lord. Because God is going to lay his hand. God is going to forgive you.
God
is going to bless
you.
God is going to give you good
life.
This is the first step you are putting into the good
life.
That step you need to put with your Lord. Let us put that step with calling forgiveness from the Lord. So that we can go ahead and do good things on you. Because there's not any other way. There's not any other way. That we can get everything and bless before the Lord.
Zima.
And just like you are crying,
God is not going to
everything that you have done wrong before the Lord, it's automatically written before Him. God said He's the only person who cleans you from all the sins that were that you've been through. And what are you waiting for? This is the world that we can have some healing in. He said this is the world that He can heal us, and if it is not His mercy, none of us will be able to come before Him now. I was standing before you, I would have died a long time ago. With the sins that I've been through, if God did not have mercy on me, I would have not been here today. But let's see His goodness. You ask for forgiveness from Him and God will not let you. He will hold your hand and say, come my son. And He will bless you at that time. You will see your life change. You will see many things come to your life. That will make you know that our Lord is the true God. Let us not go back. We should not never go back. Because God knows if we are going to go back, God knows the things that we are going to go back. That's why He said, let us all leave our evil doings and let's come back to Him. The Bible says, let us watch and wait for the Lord, just like a watchman or a security guard waiting for the morning to come. Let us wait for the Lord just like the watchman is waiting for the morning to come, because we all know that He is going to come and then He is going to forgive us in everything that we have done. My brothers and sisters, just like Jesus said when He was captured, and in our last reading, in the book of John,
Yohana 7.
John chapter 7.